In this video, we're going to take a look at what's new with the Messages app on the iPhone with iOS 18. Now, if you find this video helpful, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at what's new with the Messages app on the iPhone with iOS 18. Let's go over to my iPhone. Let's first look at the new text effects. So I'm in my Messages app here, and let's just go and type in a simple yes here. We're just going to type in yes. Now, instead of sending it, I'm not going to tap on the blue button. I don't want to send it. What I would like to do is send it with a text effect. Now, in the past, what we were able to do is long press on this, and when I long press on it, and we still can do that, as you can see, what I'm able to do is send the text as a bubble, and we have all these different options here. Or what I could do is I could send it as a full screen effect here, and then I just swipe back and forth to choose my screen effect. Once I choose my text effect, I tap on the blue button here. But we're not going to do that. We have new text effects with iOS 18, and they're not located in the screen. So basically what we have to do is we have to get out of the screen. So I am going to tap on the X here. We need to get out of this. And now what I need to do is I need to find those new text effects. Well, Apple placed them right underneath this icon here to the far right, where we have our suggested replies and things like that. Well, when I tap on that icon, what I'm able to do is apply any one of these text effects. So if I wanted to go with a simple nod, I tap on nod, and when I do, you're going to see that yes now is nodding. Now to send it, all I have to do is just tap on the blue circle here and it'll send it with that text effect. If you want to go back to the keyboard, maybe you want to retype something or change what you're putting in there, what you need to do is you just need to tap in this area here. And when I do, it's going to bring me back over to my regular keyboard. So those are the new text effects. We just tap on that once we start typing. Another new option we have is we can attach emojis to a reply. Now you may be familiar with reactions. Reactions are thumbs up. So when I go over to this message here and I long press on it, this is nothing new. What I'm able to do is apply any one of these reactions. That's what these are called, are reactions. Well, now in addition to that, you're going to see when we go over to the far right, I can also apply an emoji. To select my emoji, what I do is I just tap on the gray circle here, the smiley face, the keyboard pops up, the emoji keyboard, and then from here I'm able to select from any one of the emojis. So let's just go with a simple thumbs up. I tap on it, and instead of the reactions, what it's going to do is it's going to apply that emoji. So in addition to reactions, we can also apply emojis. The next feature that we're going to look at is one of my favorite new features in the Messages app. What we can do is we can now schedule messages. This is great for birthdays. I've already used this for birthdays. If it's someone's birthday in a couple of days, what you're able to do is type in here, happy birthday, and then instead of sending it now, you can schedule it to send at a later date. So how do we do that? Well, basically, instead of tapping on the blue circle, we don't want to send it right now, so we don't tap on the blue circle. What we need to do is we need to tap on the plus here. So let's just say I wanted to schedule this. I tap on the plus. We have some tools that pop up here. This is nothing new. I can open up the camera, attach a photo, share my location. Again, nothing new. But what is new is we have send later. So now I just tap on send later. I set when I want it to send. So let's just go with tomorrow. And now to send it, all I have to do is just tap on this blue circle here, but instead of sending it now, what it's going to do is it's going to send it at Tuesday, October 8 at 7 p.m. So let's go ahead and schedule it. Tap on the blue arrow here, and now it is scheduled. And you can see that it is scheduled. So now tomorrow it will automatically send that. So that's how we can schedule messages or send later, as Apple calls it. One of my favorite new features with the Messages app. Now let's take a look at Apple Intelligence. If you have an iPhone that supports Apple Intelligence, there are a couple of other new features. One of them is suggested replies. And this is kind of hit and miss. Now, I am using a beta here, so it's not going to work right now. It did work earlier today, but I can just kind of tell you how it works. Basically, when someone asks a question here and you go and start typing here, when we look at this little area here, what you're going to see are suggestions. So Apple Intelligence will look at the question there, and then it'll suggest a reply. And then from there, you can choose that reply, or what we can do is just start typing your own reply. Again, that is hit and miss with me, but I am using a beta version, so maybe they're still working on that. The other new feature with Apple Intelligence is writing tools. What we can do is we can have the iPhone proofread what we write as an example. We can have it offer suggestions. So how do we get to these writing tools? Well, basically, we just have to start writing. So I'm just going to start typing in here. I'm just going to go, yes, let's have lunch. Now, what I would like to do is have Apple Intelligence take a look at this and proofread it, or maybe even rewrite it. That's what writing tools allows us to do. It'll look at it and then it'll rewrite it. How do we get to these writing tools? Well, basically what we need to do is we just need to select it. So I'm just going to select it here. And then you're going to see in the little pop-up menu, writing tools. When I tap on writing tools, a card comes up from the bottom. And then from here, I can proofread it. I can also rewrite it. I can make it sound more friendly or professional. And then on top of that, what I'm able to do is take a look at a summary. I can take a list. I can insert a table. So we have different options in there. So let's just go ahead and make it more friendly. So I tap on friendly. And now you can see it rewrote it and it says, let's have a scrumptious lunch. From here, what I'm able to do is go back to the original, or what I can do is I can rewrite it. I'm going to keep it, so let's just go ahead and send it. I tap on the blue arrow, and now it sent that rewritten response. So that's how we can get to our writing tools from within the Messages app. We select the text, the pop-up menu will show up, and then from there we can go and apply any Apple Intelligence rewrites. So that is what is new with the Messages app on the iPhone with iOS 18. We have new text effects. We can apply emojis to responses. And my favorite new feature is we can also schedule messages or send them later. And then if you have Apple Intelligence, you can have it format a response for you or have a suggested reply for you. And you can apply writing tools. So that is what is new with the Messages app on the iPhone with iOS 18. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video, you can subscribe to my channel, you can share it with your friends and family. In addition to that, what you may want to do is check out danstutorials.com. Although I do have over 400 videos on YouTube, I have over 2,000 videos on my site, danstutorials.com. I've been doing this a lot longer on my site than I have YouTube. So how can you help support the site? Well, the site is a membership-based site. You can look at all the videos for free, but when you do become a member, what I do is I take out all of the ads. I also have an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius, so you can go and ask it questions. And then I also host webinars and classes on a regular basis, and you have access to those. But most important, you're also helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of a small house here that I do this. I'm not part of some big organization or anything like that. So when you become a member, you are directly supporting my efforts in creating these videos. So check out Dan's tutorials for more information, and thanks for watching.